So, I've been looking forward to this game. This is probably the game that nobody is looking forward to but me. But this is the third game in a series made by one guy, which I think they go by Lake Fapird. They have had a history of making some pretty decent Sonic fan games, which has also got some banging music in it, and they have continued by making their own original IP, Do Not Steal. In all seriousness, though, I do love Spark the Electric Jester a lot. I've streamed the past two games before. I've streamed one, I've streamed two, and now we're going to stream three. I did play the demo for this about a year ago, and the game came out a few days back, so that's what we're going to be checking out now, and I'm looking forward to this. I think this will be a great game to play. Let's just hope that OBS can capture this correctly. I actually did briefly test this game out on my Steam Deck, and it works pretty much perfectly, but I'm going to be playing it on the PC just for convenience. So I've been fucking around a lot with that Steam Deck. It's a really good piece of hardware. Hey there, Cray. You're just in time for Spark. So yeah, I did a test of like one save file just to see how it ran on the Steam Deck. So I'm gonna do a new save file here. Platforming difficulty normal. Originally intended difficulty, but it might still feel a little bit too twitchy for some players. Please take your time to learn the game with this one. Combat difficulty, Electric Jester. Might be best for first time players, but might still be a little hard if you're not used to this type of game. Right, well, I've played Spark 2 before, so maybe I'll go with this one. For those looking for a little more challenge, your health is halved compared to the previous difficulty. Special mode where you can only take two hits and you cannot hold your block. As compensation, you will also deal more damage by default. Right, I'm gonna do Hard Jester then because I've played Spark 2. Yours has been having some hardware issues. Well, that's unfortunate. Right, so here's our protagonist. For those that have never seen these games before, that is Spark, the Electric Jester. So, no explanation, right off the bat, he's just like driving a fucking police car. And you're thinking, oh, I'll jump out of a car to like, you know, light platform, but nope, this is the first level of the game. Okay, that's. Okay, X is drift. Sorry, I was trying to press the trigger button to drift there. I don't know if this is a police car, it just looks like a Formula One car or some shit like that, but yeah, this is giving me some like Sega arcade vibes right now. Alright, note to self, don't touch those. So wait, is that actually hurting me? I'm not sure. Like, my health is not going down. You're 90% certain you've got carpal tunnel in your right hand. God, that sucks. I hope you get that looked at then and see if you can, you know, hopefully find your way to recovering from that. You know, with the amount of gaming I've done in my life, I'm surprised I haven't succumbed to carpal tunnel myself. I feel like that's. Whoa! Well, no time like the present. as soon as I can find it. Sorry, I wasn't prepared. Fuck. Where is it? Here it is.
Spin!
Sorry, I forgot I had a soundboard folder. I was scrambling to find it. Also, why can't I get off? What the hell? I'm actually trying to get back down. Okay, we're off to a good start. I'm actually, like, trying to get back down. Okay, there we go. I feel like, finishing my thought there, I feel like I'm gonna end up getting carpal tunnel in the next few years. I'm starting to get to that age now. Yes, the advanced age of 36. Right, so you think, okay, now it's time for some platforming, so we're gonna see some cool stuff. So it teaches you a couple mechanics here. And then that's the end of the level. The next level is the actual platforming level. Right, so this game kind of follows the Sonic Adventure sort of like school of design, where it's like if a level you complete, you get these things called Freedom Medals, which are like the emblems from those games. But I think in this game, the Freedom Medals are actually required for progression, so I may have to replay some earlier levels to like get, you know, more medals for the later levels. Which I think I'm fine with that, because it does, you know, give you a bit more variety and stuff to do. If a stage has a special set of goals, completing them will reveal a set of surprises later in the game. Those special goals are speed medals, score medals, and explore medals. Speed medals can be obtained by beating a stage quickly. You can see the threshold for obtaining a speed medal in the world map after you select your desired stage. Not all stages have speed medals, though. Score medals can be obtained by getting a certain amount of score. You can see the amount necessary in the world map before selecting a stage. Not all the stages will have this. Score is obtained for collecting collectibles, destroying enemies, and objects. Not all objects are destructible. You can even get more score by increasing your multiplier. Everything that increases your score also increases your multiplier. But collecting bits is the best way to increase your multiplier. You can also find exploration medals. There are 10 hidden in every stage. Some stages might have less than 10 though. Alright. So I may have to revisit some earlier levels to like do some of that stuff if necessary, but for now we can progress, I think. So the level we just did was Area 01, Terminal Village, Alpine Carrera. Terminal Village, Double Moon Villa. Also, here's a shop where you can buy upgrades and stuff, so we're gonna have a look there first. Oh, I don't have any bits yet. I think the bits are kinda like this game's coins, or rings. So I will come back to the shop once I have some monies. Carpal tunnel fucking sucks. I'm pretty sure I've had it for a few years, but I didn't take the problem seriously enough before. Yeah, let's hope that you didn't suffer any permanent damage with that. To unlock more stages, you will need Freedom Medals, FM. Each stage you beat will give you one Freon medal. You can review all of this in the pause menu. Alright. So yeah, for those that haven't seen this before, it's basically a 3D Sonic game, but it's actually like the kind of 3D Sonic game that people want. And I say that as somebody who's looking forward to Sonic Frontiers, but we all know that Sonic hasn't had the most, like, spotless of, like, track records in terms of, like, 3D games. There's also a little bit of combat in this game as well. Oh. Right, LB is my parry button. Good to know. But yeah, there's combat as well. You can parry, you can attack, you can jump, you can dash. You can do all sorts. And I just went over there instead. So yeah, these little diamond things are your bits, so I'm gonna try and collect those. Let's see, how do I do that thing? There we go. So to do a homing dash on an opponent, you have to like press RT and then press B. So I'm gonna have to like get used to that. Like, Spark has a lot of moves compared to Sonic, so some moves require like a combination of buttons, like two different buttons to like get it to work. But yeah, check this out. This feels very much like Sonic. And when you go around the loops, like, you get full control over what you're doing. It's not like it's autopiloting. Ah, I see. We're going that way. Right. What is this? I don't know why I just picked up there, but I have it now, so... So yeah, this game so far feels really fucking good. Also, you can wall run. Wonder if I can do this. Let's see. Nope. Oh Jesus. Good. I've already forgotten how to wall jump. Either that or you cannot wall jump there. Right, fuck it, let's just continue. Yeah, in the first game, Spark has kind of like a Kirby thing where he can get like different abilities. I'm not sure if that's still in this game. Like, in the second game, you don't even play as Spark. In the second game, you play as the robotic doppelganger, Fark. But yeah, in this game, you get to play as Spark, so I'm not really sure if that's here or not. Like, I'm picking up these capsules, but I don't know what they do yet. It doesn't seem to be telling me. That's the checkpoint ring. Gotta go through that. How's the game looking so far? Like, is it looking fine on OBS? Oh, I see a thing up there. Nice. Score multiplier. I don't know if I'm going backward or not. I think this is the way forward. Look at my score multiplier, 15. Right, I guess this is the way we're going. So we got rail grinding, kind of like Sonic Heroes and modern Sonic games. In fact, there are some levels that are designed purely around like rail grinding, but it's actually done really well in this game. Like, it will explain the rail grinding mechanics a little bit better in the next level, I think, or like in one of the near future levels. I think I got a medal for getting a high score because I got a lot of score multipliers there. Might just be me, but the background looks like it has way too much visual clutter. Honestly, I didn't even notice because I was focusing on Spark, but I guess I could kind of see that. I could kind of see what you mean by that. Alright, time for some story. Ah, there you are. For context, I'm Yur. Some conscious. Just here to catch you up on what's been going on, got it? Before you go back to whatever you were doing, let's go over everything that led us here. So where's Spark, a simple formie living his life? I like how they took a screenshot from the first game, like that is an actual picture from the first game's cutscenes. The first game is in 2D by the way, the second and third games are in 3D. After we graduated from college, we tried our best to find a job, but we had no luck. We even became a street performer once. That's how we have this hat. And yeah, we built it ourselves. It gave us electrical powers. And then everyone's robot started to go on a rampage. That's how it all started. Apparently it was all orchestrated by this guy. Briom. And something called Clarity, apparently. Yeah, well, keep that in mind for later, okay? Anyways, this is when we went in our journey to stop him. And it's where we met this guy. He's complicated. Yeah, that guy there is Fark. So we have Spark and Fark. So like, he was supposed to be Freom's son, somehow. And Freom built him to eventually replace him. And it's by mere coincidence that he ended up looking like me. It's crazy talk. As you can probably tell, we don't even really buy this story. More than likely he's just another tyrant. Like his so-called dad. And no surprise, he eventually defeated Freom. Now he runs an organization appropriately called the Fark Force. Why, you ask? To stop Clarity, they say. Clarity is the evil program that will infect everything to take over the worlds. Yeah, right. Now the world has become completely militarized. The internet was shut down and we couldn't travel anymore. Everywhere you go, you see his goons. Man, I hate this faker. So wait, apparently Fark is the villain in this game? And to top it all off, he totally stole my looks. He's even named his army after himself. What a total narcissist. Oh, he didn't know what else to name it, he says. And finally that brings us to us. Remember that check from Armstrong? Yeah, well, all that money was suddenly gone. Internet was down, couldn't access it. Had to go to the bank to get it. As you can imagine, the lines were huge! And that's when I had enough. And here we are. Down with the Fark Force! Let's tell them down like there's no tomorrow! Come on, let's go! Alright, well there's your motivation for Sparks-like story. So apparently Fark has caused a bit of like a... What's the word I'm looking for? Oh, there is a lot of levels here. Whoa. That is a lot of fucking levels to pick from. Also, this world map seems fucking huge. So wait, is this all going to be filled with like various challenges and stages? Oh my god. This is going to take a while to get through. Challenge 03, charge jester dash. Slope jumping, jester dash. Right, let's try these challenge stages because they'll teach you some mechanics. Slope jumping. So as you can tell by just watching this, the controls are very good. Doesn't feel super twitchy or like difficult to control like Sonic games can be at times. It's very easy to understand. There we go. Easy. I think I heard Spark dying there because I fell off the back end of that. Oh, I get a medal for completing that as well. Nice. But yeah, I think my original VODs for Spark 1 and 2 are still on my YouTube channel. Like, I streamed those games years ago. So if you ever want to like get caught up on like the story and like me playing the original games, they're on there. Jester Dash. Right, so we'll do the challenge stages, then we'll do the actual levels. Because I'll be getting Freon medals doing these as well, which is important. Press the Jester Dash button to immediately destroy a small enemy. Oh, there we go. I was trying to like move forward there, but it kept pushing me backwards. There we go. Very quick and snappy. I like it. And it's very easy to walk onto the right target. This game is made by one person, by the way. I mean, technically that's not true. Like, there is like, you know, composers and stuff, but the pretty much the whole game is programmed by one person. So that is fucking impressive that they made this. And it, you know, it doesn't suck. Oh. I don't know why sometimes I go backwards like that though. Oh, fuck. I guess because I didn't use the speed booster. Oh, that's how you do it. If I knew I needed that, I would have ran through it. I didn't think that was necessary. Oh god. Oh damn. No. No. There we go. Was a little bit slow there, but I managed to get through it. Again, this is like tutorial stuff essentially. But it's kind of worth going through anyway, because again, getting these medals for completing them. I think the game is pretty much heavily encouraging that you get these medals. Otherwise you'll be stuck. and have to like backtrack and get some more. But challenge 3, the charged Jester Dash. Please don't forget to check all of your moves within the pause menu. LT plus B for charge Jester Dash. Okay, so it's basically the... It's basically the, like, the spin dash that Sonic can do. What am I doing? Sorry. That's twice now where I pressed jump slightly too late because I was trying to jump off the edge there. There. So while you have that activated, the charge dash thing, you can basically aim where you want to go. So you're not like stuck facing one direction. Oh, you can do it in midair as well, okay. That's kind of useful. I like that. Oh god, I don't like that though. Yeah, shite. Overshot. See that spring for some reason. There we go. Right, so besides those three challenge missions, we also have three actual levels to play. Which will then, you know, spawn, which will like, not spawn, what's the word I'm looking for? They will spread out into even more challenges and stages that we can do, so it seems like there's like multiple paths you can take for now. What do you think of the Steam Deck's battery, especially since it's all... I've already mentioned before that I struggle to get over 90 minutes on most games. I haven't played it in handheld mode that much yet because I've been using like a USB HDMI display hub thing so that I can like have it on my TV just to like try on there. Having said that, I do agree that the battery life is a little bit on the short end, but when you consider the amount of technology that's built into the thing, I'm not really surprised by that. I could see them, you know, upping the battery life with like a revision, like if they made a Steam Deck 2, but I don't know when that's gonna happen, maybe like a couple years from now that'll happen. Right, so we've got Terminal Village, high-rise tracks. What's that say? Gold? I don't know if that says gold or old or... Gold Dry Desert? Question mark? AM Village. Well, let's try the village one. Find all the medals before the timer runs out. Get coins to complete the stage. In this stage, you'll need to collect medals before the timer runs out, right? So not all levels are just going to be like going from A to B. There'll be like challenge levels as well, it seems like. You don't need to collect them all, just a set amount. Oh, I see a typo. Keep in mind, I think like for Pird, the first language is not English, so I can kind of like, you know, excuse that. I'm not sure what their nationality is, I think it might be French. I'm not 100% sure on that one. Good luck! Right, so I need 9 more medals. There's one. You know what that sound effect reminds me of? That sound? It reminds me of that, like, slap sound effect that's in fucking Terminal Montage animations. Oh yeah, apparently there's a new Terminal Montage animation for Kirby. I haven't watched it yet. I need to check that one out. Oh god. There's a coin. Oh god. I'm finding more multipliers than I am coins, so not sure where the finds. See a multiplier down there. Maybe there's a coin here as well. I saw a video for a game that I thought looked pretty good. Hang on a second. I will check it in a minute. I'm hoping my internet doesn't start to shit the bed because I'm downloading the video right now so I can have a look at it. I'll just continue the game while that's happening. I don't see any more medals. I'm still looking for them. Wait, is the medals in the water? Oh fuck. There's one. Yeah. I'm still getting used to the controls. The controls are a little bit complicated, but once you understand them, it's good. Because certain moves require certain button combinations, I need to like get used to those. Oh fuck. I guess I could just do that instead. Oh shit. The hell? You can take fall damage? Fall damage in a platformer. Alright. I don't know, did I take damage there? Because it looked like he did. I wasn't paying attention to the health bar when that happened. One. Fucking hell. I don't know how to heal myself. Maybe the capsules heal you? Okay, they do heal you. Well, the orange ones do anyway. Oh god. Oh, I see one down there. There's one. Okay, turns out I think there is like a fall damage system in place. Did it with 25 seconds to spare. Right, I think the video's downloaded now. I'll have a look at it in just a moment. Right, so I guess I'm gonna have a quick look at that then. I'm just gonna mute this for a moment while I get that set up. So apparently this is a Switch game. Hang on a second, I see the logo for it. Let me just get the video up on the screen. The best, the craziest, the biggest party game. It just looks... it looks like WarioWare. Do you think this music's gonna get content claimed on YouTube? Ultra Mega Extra Party Challenge. So yeah, it kinda looks like WarioWare. I guess I'd be down for that, maybe. I mean, it looks like visually, it looks kinda weird, but that's not necessarily a bad thing. I don't know, it's different, but it does very much have that WarioWare energy. As long as it's good, I'd be down for it. But yeah, the fucking... I guess you're avoiding the bowling balls as a, you know, bowling pin. Flattening that, and what the fuck is happening there? Like, you're being attacked by fucking doges? Like, what the hell is going on there? I don't understand that one. I like how, like, you see them, like, kind of leaning forward a little bit, but then you get one frame that's like, whoop! Like, it just quickly goes there, just to flip forward. But yeah, this seems to have some promise. It does look a bit like WarioWare-ish. Right, okay. I have a bunch of bits now, so I guess I can go to the shop and buy some stuff. So, extra moves, extra powers, upgrades, jester powers, and back to map. Speed buff. Hyper surge. This one lets you release a powerful explosion. You need a full energy bar for this one, though. Energy dash. With this, you can do a very fast dash forward. I'm sure you'll make good use of this one. Overcharge. This module lets you charge your power into, well, more power. You'll definitely hit harder while it's active. Oh, I see, so it's like a combat-focused ability. Snap Portal. This one ain't cheap, but it's a special one. It's military tech. Same tech that they use to teleport goons. You can use this module to teleport directly to the nearest enemy. Don't forget to assign it to a slot. This one's quite big. Well, look at that. Put this on your ear and you'll be able to see interesting stuff that's around you. Very useful to find hidden stuff. Don't forget to assign this to a slot. Multi-shot. This module lets you channel your power into a barrage of blasts. It may not deal much damage, but it should help with that combo meter of yours. Let's see what else we got here. Spin charge. Oh. Hold the light attack button to release a big spin attack that hits everything around you. An extra attack is added to the aerial heavy attack. Oh, I didn't realize I had the heavy attack. I guess that's the Y button. Press heavy attack after all the light attacks for an extra finisher. Skyward slash. Double down spin. There is a lot of stuff here. Duplex slash. Press the light attack button after you finish a heavy attack combo to unleash a strong upward slash that sends the enemies flying upward. This one sounds like it could be useful for combos. Right, I'm going to... Let's have a look at upgrades. Regen breaking bits. Oh, it's a fucking ring dash from Sonic. The light speed dash. That's interesting. Zoom across a line of bits at high speeds. If you're already going fast, zooming across the line of bits will make you go faster. So wait, this one's automatic? I guess it's designed to be like that, so you don't need to press a button. But that's fine then, I'll buy that. And once I get some more bits, I'll upgrade my combat abilities. Cold dry, that's what it is. Get to the goal before the timer runs out. In this stage, you have to finish the stage before the timer runs out. Go for it! Oh god. Jesus. So that was a bad time to jump, wasn't it? So wait, did my timer not reset? I don't know what time it was when I started. Hang on a second. Let me go back a moment. I don't think my time actually reset there and it put me back to the start. Yeah, it didn't reset my timer. I knew it. So I like how there's some levels designed just for like going through it fast. I don't know how they do the light speed dash though. I'm not really sure how you activate that one. I thought it was automatic, but it doesn't seem to be. Another Freon medal. Or Freedom Medal, sorry, not Freon. The fuck am I talking about? Freedom Medal. High Rise Tracks. Right, so this is a standard level, get to the goal. Nope. You fuck. Sorry, I stopped for a moment because I wanted to test something. Guess the swipe. Oh wait, do I have to hold the button? Is that how that works? I'm not even sure how to do that, to be honest. Yeah, I think you just hold the button down when you get to it. Whoa! Holy shit! That was cool. I kind of like this. It definitely feels like a, you know, a 3D Sonic thing. Fairly short level, that one. I know there's like at least one level that revolves around grinding because I remember that from the demo that I played like a year ago. So I think I got a challenge done. I'm not even sure if I did there. Right, so what's next? Special training? What is this? Oops. I need to remember that I've got like a button that lets me like block or parry. I guess I can test the parry mechanic then. There we go. That's how you do that. The fuck? Oh, so it's like you mash the button to escape. Okay, so when it's green, they're gonna do a command grab. Or, like, they're just gonna grab you, essentially. And when it's red, that's when you can parry. I get it. Oops. Right, where do I go next? Oh, there it is, right, so there's a boss fight now. Defeat the boss. Bigger enemies need to be attacked to be destroyed. Make sure to check the All Moves page in the pause menu to know your moves. Some moves can launch enemies into the air. Combo bar. The higher the bar, the more damage you deal, but hitting enemies with the same attack over and over again won't raise your bar. The Steam Deck can emulate the PS3 very well. That's cool. The only like relatively recent system that I tried emulating on the Steam Deck was the 3DS, and sadly, it's like very choppy and slow, so that one's not really, unless I didn't have the settings set up correctly, it was like going very slow for me. But yeah, that's cool that you can emulate PS3 stuff on it decently. Combat basics, you can hold the parry button to block attacks, do it right before the attack to gain a lot of energy and stun the enemy. Red warning, you see this over the enemy, he is about to attack. This attack can be parried. Yellow warning, the enemy is about to attack, but this one cannot be parried. Right, so avoid yellow. Green, the enemy is about to grab you, this cannot be parried. Oh yeah, I've tried GameCube emulation on Steam Deck. I've tried like Kirby's Air Ride and it works perfectly on it. Nice. Oops. Yeah, pretty much got the combat down. Alright, phase two. Transformers. Soon there. There we go. Shit. I keep parrying a little bit too early. Yeah! There we go. There he goes. Nice. So yeah, the combat's alright. I'm a little bit sloppy at it, but I'll get better, I think. I do like the design of Spark. He's a pretty neat looking character. Like, he would fit in with, like, you know, the mascot platformers of the 90s. Right, well, that's the first boss done. Let's continue. Area 2. Dry Neon Desert. Lost Riviera, Klonoa Fantasy Reverie. Grinding on rails. Jump on a rail to ride that rail. Press the dash button to dash on the rail. You can build up speed on a downhill by crouching. Beware, the crouching uphill will make you lose speed. Oh, it's kind of like Sonic Heroes, right? Okay. Point your analog stick toward the rail you want to switch toward when you see a target, and you will be able to jump to that with the gesture dash button. So, direction plus B. Got it. So yeah, remember Sonic Heroes and how like the rail dash, the rail grinding was like a big part of that game. There was like some levels designed around it, like Rail Canyon. Right, well this game does that as well, but I think this game actually does it the right way. Like for one, it doesn't feel like a piece of shit. It really does feel like Rail Canyon. But yeah, you look how easy this is. To like switch between these two. Oh yeah, X button to crouch, got to remember that. Crouch on the downs. There we go. I like that you can just do an infinite mini dash just to keep your momentum going. But yeah, it seems like they give you plenty of freedom to like do a bunch of cool shit in terms of platforming, which I absolutely love. This is basically what Sonic Heroes should have been, to be honest. Like, this actually feels really fun. Oh god. I almost overshot that there. And it's so easy to jump onto the correct rail as well. Nice! Oh, that's so fucking good, I love that. Nothing over there. Continue on this path then. Again, you see how easy that is? Like, you try doing that shit in Sonic Heroes, you will fucking die. But I kinda wanna stream Sonic Heroes, not because I love that game, more so the opposite. Like, I loved it when it first came out, but let me tell you something, that game has not aged very well. Like, that game is, like, one of the jankiest Sonic games I have ever played. And that game came out after Sonic Adventure and Sonic Adventure 2. Wait, what's over here? Can I get up there? I'm not even sure if I can run up a wall. I don't think I can. I'll just pick up this multiplier and move on. Again, with the terminal montage slaps. So yeah, I remember this level being in the demo, and I remember really enjoying playing it then. I don't know if they've refined the mechanics or the level design since then. It's been a year since I played that demo, but it still feels really fun to play. And yes, you can even jump to a rail that's like a little bit higher to the one adjacent. Like, it seems like the developer went to great lengths to make the rail grinding and transitioning between rails, you know, as painless as possible. Like, you can tell they were a fan of the concept in Sonic Heroes and wanted to, like, do it better. And I must say, they certainly did it way better than that game. Nope, don't want to go that way. Oh, fuck, right. Gotta watch out for that, I guess. So I think I mentioned it recently, but there's a Sonic fan game that came out very recently, and I've been saying recently a lot, haven't I? But yeah, it came out about a week or two ago, and I want to stream it. It's called Sonic Triple Trouble 16-bit, and apparently it's really good, so I kind of want to play it. I might stream that. For now, I'm going to be focusing on this. Maybe I'll check that one out in the near future. Again, a little bit sloppy there, but hey, at least I tried, and at least I didn't die. There we go. So yeah, isn't that so much better than Rail Canyon from Sonic Heroes? Like, it's fucking miles better than that. Again, you try to do half the shit that I did in this level in that game, and you're just gonna die every single time. That game doesn't really leave a lot of room for, you know, improvisation and, like, experimenting. This game seems to give you a ton of options to, like, navigate around those kind of levels. Oh? Does this game have voice acting? Oh? Oh shit. Freeom? Wait, what? Well, it looks like Freeom, but I don't think it's actually him. Oh right, parry button. Oh fuck. Oh! I am getting my ass handed to me right now. Oh, that's why, because it's scripted. Well, that just fucking happened. Once there was a castle. It was a fancy castle, the best of its kind. The castle had a guardian, guarding it every day and night, all alone. The guardian was very good at his job, but nonetheless, he was just a young boy. But one day, deep within the castle, something came into being, something special. While the guardian patrolled the castle, he heard a voice coming through the walls. It was a girl, a kind girl. In secret, away from the castle staff, the boy and the girl began to talk in secret. In no time, the boy and the girl became very good friends. It was because of their friendship that, in secret, the girl manifested a body of her own. From here on, the relationship continued to grow and grow and grow. And this is when the girl had revealed her secrets. "We're special," she said. "The whole castle was built to convince me," she continued, "or to conceive me. You are my treasured guardian, and together we have a destiny." The girl continued to explain what made her special. She explained that she had a higher level of consciousness and looked at everyone with pity, and they were not able to perceive the world as she did. The boy was fascinated by the girl from that day onward. The boy and the girl had formed an even stronger bond. But unfortunately for the two, one day, the castle staff found out about the two and took the girl away from the boy. The young guardian was overcome with anger and sorrow. He mourned for days, which quickly turned into weeks. In those days, he deeply reflected about her and the castle staff. He did not like the castle staff. They were distant, never came close unless absolutely necessary. He was always alone, ever since he came into being. She was the only one who made him feel complete. But one day, he heard her voice, coming from the walls. The girl had returned. This time, without her body. At first, the boy thought the castle staff had permanently changed her. But she was overcome with joy when she realized she was still the same as she once was. "I just had to act nice," she continued. From that day on, they promised to see each other. From that day on, they promised to each other that they would fulfill their destinies, together. Their destiny. To rid the world of meaningless life. The girl wished to share her higher level of being with everyone else. Bring a new, brighter world. To this goal, the boy adopted a new, more domineering personality. A name and the remote controlled body. A new name and the remote controlled body. This pleased the girl. Together, they banished the castle staff and forcefully persuaded every robot to follow their will. With everything in place, their plan was set in motion. So wait, is this like lore for Freom and why he came into being? But the boy felt a deepening anxiety. He knew he was inferior to the girl. He did not share her level of consciousness. He could never have had her level of consciousness. So he had an idea. Together with the girl, they conceived a child. It would be created by her, built on his image. The child that was created with an unlimited potential. A potential that he would grow into over the course of his life. Their child would take the place of someone else, and set out on the world with only one goal. To kill his own father and take his place. Holy shit. Yeah, so this is Freeholm's backstory and how he and Fark came into being. None of this was explained in the first two games, by the way, like, we're only just learning this now. But the boy had one final wish for his child. He wished that the child would be sent out with no memories of who he was or why he was created. He wanted the child to realise his destiny by himself, just like he did. With the child being conceived, it eased the boy's anxiety. Feeling better, they proceeded with their plan. And with that, this marks the end of our tale. Alright. Well, that was a bit of an info dump there. Interesting. Right, we've got some more levels to check out. High speeds, get to the goal. Wait. Okay, yeah, these are challenge levels, right, so we'll do them in order. Oh, fuck, no. Oh, bitch. Okay, yeah, there is fall damage. There we go. Just gotta keep mashing that mini dash button just to get extra momentum up there. There we go. Easy. Another Freedom Medal. So I'm wondering if that Guardian is actually Freeholm, because I thought he died at the end of the second game. Possibly not. So yeah, that just raises some questions for me. Right, so challenge 5, wall jumping. Get to the goal. Jump from wall to wall. I like this colour palette. The colour palette also affects Spark, I've noticed. It's a nice touch. Alright, that was easy. Challenge 6, wall walking. Get to the goal. Learn to wall walk. Oh. Well, I would wall walk if the game would let me. Oh, oh, oh. I haven't quite understood it yet. This may take a few tries. Wait, what the fuck? Duh. I think I need to jest or dash across it, actually. Oh fuck, I can't do more than one. Ah, crap. Yeah, I'm not entirely sure how to do this. The game's not telling me how to do it, which is the annoying thing. Oh no, okay. Yeah, I'm gonna have to figure this one out. Why? I mean, I almost did it. Ah! Game, could you maybe tell me how to do this, please? That would be lovely. Kinda got it to work. Wait a minute. I still don't get that. I thought I had it there, but I mean, it's good to learn this now. Motherfucker. Like, I get it on the first one, but then I lose all momentum. I don't know how to, like, you know, continue that. But let me try something. But I'm gonna fail on purpose because I need to pay attention to something. I'm gonna trial and error this till I figure it out, so bear with me. Okay, I kinda get it now. So the reason that wasn't working before is because I was like holding toward the wall a little bit, like in a sort of angle. But you need to hold forward the whole time while holding R, or RT. If you don't do those, that won't work. Right, I understand now. I'm surprised it took me that long to figure out, but... Ah, shit. Fuck. Yeah, once you stop, you can't recover from that. Oh god. Yeah. I don't know if you need to hold the RT button. Yeah, you need to hold the RT button the whole time. Right, now I know how to do it consistently. I feel like there's going to be some parts later in the game. There's going to be some parts later that require that. Alright, we got this. Oh god, right. No problem. Okay, now this looks like the triangle jump from Sonic Heroes. You're gonna be hearing me compare Sonic Heroes a lot, I think. Oh, what the fuck? Oh jeez. Okay, that's interesting. Having curves to that so that you don't know what's about to come around the corner. Right, well, I kind of understand it now. It took me a little bit to figure that out, but I get it now. Again, it's a good thing the game lets me, you know, have a chance to figure that one out, because it's probably going to throw some stuff with that later. So, best to have learned that early. Right, so that is a stage, but I don't want to do that yet. I want to check out these other levels. Lost Ravine, Canyon Zero, Everett Hole. Find all the medals before the time runs out. Okay. So we'll play through Area 2, and then I'm going to call it a night after that, because I've been streaming for a good while now at this point. As much as I want to continue playing this game, I want to pace myself a little bit. I don't know how many areas are in this game, but there must be quite a few of them if the map size is anything to go by. So this is just an open area with coins to find, so I'm gonna go look for them. I see two. There's one up here. Oh god. Alright, got it. And then there's one down there. Hey, check that out. And there's one down here as well. I'll grab that other one in a little bit. I'm gonna go get this coin. This one seems easier to find, easier to reach. Again, just need to collect 10 coins, that's all I gotta do. Nice. I know I missed a coin back there, but I'm trying to like get the ones that are a little bit harder to reach, and I'll go back for that. Oh, there's one in there. I'm doing way better on this stage than I was on the other stage that required collecting little medals. Oh fuck. One there. One left. Right. And we are done. Did that with plenty of time to spare. That was a fun little, like, stage. I do like that it's not just strictly go from A to B, like there's some little like side missions and challenges you can do, just for added variety. We got another stage here. Lost Ravine, Canyon Zero. Get as much score as you can before the timer runs out. So I'm guessing there's like a minimum threshold for score on this one. In a raid stage, our goal is to get as much score as possible before the timer runs out. Score is obtained from collecting collectibles, destroying enemies and objects. Not all objects are destructible. You can get even more score. Oh yeah, we read this already. After a minimum amount of score has been reached, the exit door will open. Some of the exits have a total score multiplier, and if you use one of them, it will end the stage and multiply your total score. After you reach the minimum score, you can go for the gold or diamond score medals. If the timer runs out and you've reached the minimum score, the stage is completed. If not, the stage will restart. Guess I'll try to get as much points as possible then. I think I remember this stage from the demo, actually. or at least this particular mission. Speaking of remembering things, I think this is from the soundtrack of the first game. Found a hidden exploration medal. Don't know where they want me to go here. This way? Oh. Right, well, I need to get more points to open that door. Oh! Oh, right, I got that already. Assuming destroying some of the objects here, like they did say, didn't they? Destroying objects increases your score. Now, where was that room that was in before? Oh yeah, here it is. Warning, level up. Oh gods. Yeah. Ah, fuck. Yeah, I need to buy some more, like, combat-based stuff. I'm gonna do that after this mission. So the enemies that it says weak on are the ones you can home attack on, which makes sense. There we go. Wrong button. Some cool box physics you got there. Better than Sonic 06's physics, at least. Oh! Almost at 40,000. There we go. Next threshold is 150,000? Really? Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna reach that. I mean, I could try, but... I'm guessing more hard enemies are going to be around now because of all the damage I'm doing. Like, this is a new enemy. Shit. Right, I'm going to play it safe. I'm going to take the 1.5 exit because I'm down to my last hit. Almost ran right into that there. Fuck. Total score 105,000. So not quite 150,000, but whatever. I got two exploration medals as well. I'm guessing the exploration medals will give me some unlockables as I progress. Seems like there's a lot of stuff you can do here. Lost Ravine. Get to the goal. Okay. Yeah, maybe once I power myself up a little bit, I can, like, go back and try that one again. Hold the dash button while on the wall to walk on the wall. Oh, why didn't you tell me, game? Why did you fucking leave me hanging like that? I like how it doesn't tell me that until after I do the challenge level that's revolving around that. Oh, jeez. That was a bad time to dash. I dashed right fucking through that. Oh god. Can I save myself here? Nope. Do I have to collect that thing again? No, I don't need to collect that again. Lots of rails. Yep, I don't need to recollect that one. Thank you. So yeah, this feels pretty good. Like I said, it feels very much like a 3D Sonic game, but done right. Not to say that all modern Sonic games are bad, like, some of them are pretty good. I like Sonic Generations, I like Sonic Unleashed. But then you get stuff like Frontiers, or not Frontiers, Forces, you know, the one that came out a few years ago. Frontiers is later this year. I'm hoping Frontiers is good, like, I really want that to be a good game. I'm cautiously optimistic for that game. I think it's gonna be a decent, like, fun Sonic game. It better be fucking good with how much they've delayed the game. Because I think it was supposed to come out a year ago, but it didn't. Like, some people have their doubts for Sonic Frontiers, but again, I'm remaining hopeful that it will end up being a good product in the end. You know, even if some people will continue to beg to differ. And, like, especially with, like, Sonic games, you can't really please everyone, unfortunately. But yeah, I'm gonna be picking up Sonic Frontiers. God damn it! Why do they both have to start with F? My brain keeps auto-filling the wrong words. But yeah, hopefully that Frontiers ends up being a good game, is what I'm trying to say. Yep. Yeah, fuck. I'm really bad at parrying. Apparently there is a... yeah, there is. That's very well hidden. There we go. I'm finding a bunch of hidden medals in this one. Nice. Right, now for wall running. I can imagine him doing some really fucking devious stuff with the wall running later in the game. Oh. I'm not dead yet. But I'm not done yet! Uh-oh. Okay, maybe I'm gonna die now. Parry too early. Fuck it. I forgot yellow cannot be parried. Oh, I need to get the timing of that down. When you see that red flash, the timing is different for each enemy and each attack, so it's like throwing me off. Because I keep expecting it to be like the same timing, but it's not. There we go. Ooh, that's a lot of damage. Nice! I'm getting it. There we go. Yeah, combat's alright in this game, it's pretty good. Of course, having said that, the combat is not the best thing about this game. Like, the Sonic-style level design is the best thing about it. But I guess the combat does complement it a little bit, and it does make bosses interesting. But yeah, the DNA of Spark games have always had combat in them, all the way back to the first one. So it kind of makes sense to continue that idea. Beatdown Tower and Splash Grotto. So this area is not open yet. Finish before the timer runs out. This sounds like Sonic music. Sorry if I keep comparing this to Sonic a lot. It's kind of difficult to not to do that, to be honest. Look how fast I'm going. Holy shit. That momentum. It's like max speed. Oh fuck. Aw shit. I had a good run going there. Alright, here we go again. I ran out of time, for fuck's sake. Yeah, since this level doesn't have a checkpoint, you think you could reset the timer when I die? You know, not waste my time game. Right, here we go. Again, love that momentum. That's so fun. Well, I'm glad that when you get hit by things, your momentum continues. Like, you don't come to a screeching halt when you get hit, so that's good at least. Also, apparently I completed a challenge there because I see a little star medal in that corner. Yeah, I completed something, but I don't know what that medal means. Might have just been for the time alone. Dry Neon Desert, Beatdown Tower. Get to the goal. So I think this might be a full stage. So am I missing anything? Okay, it tells you about how to do your common moves here. Right, so light attack combo, air light attack combo, heavy attack. Hold the Y button for enemy launcher, so I guess that's like when you pop them up in the air so you can like do juggles. YY in the air for air heavy attack combo. Oh yeah, I haven't bought any powers and stuff yet, I need to like get to do that next. So if I hold the Y button, yeah, there you go. And then I can do that. Yeah, I really need to get good with the combat because the game's going to be demanding that. Especially when I get to the late game boss fights. Oof. Wait, is this the whole level? I'm hoping there's like an actual level to this and not just fighting. I guess this might be the whole level then. Okay, how did that hit me? Yeah, that seemed to be the whole level. I mean, if nothing else, it serves as a, you know, as a training for like improving on your combat. I think I've improved a little bit. Barely, but, you know. I think I learned a couple things about the combat play. But I think now would be a good time to actually check the shop, see what I can buy. I've got lots of money now. I've got nearly 2,000 bits to spend. Nothing here just yet. I guess I need to wait until a certain point in the game to do that. This one doesn't really tell you how to do it. Like, it doesn't tell you what button. Maybe I've got to pause the game and check what that is. Oh, I see. That could be useful, maybe. But I'm not gonna buy that yet. Speed buff. Overcharge. You'll definitely hit harder when this is active. Yeah, you know what? I'm gonna buy that. To use the power, you need to assign it to a slot. Follow the input instructions on the right. Spin charge. An extra attack is added to the aerial heavy combo. I'll buy that. Press heavy attack after all the light attacks for an extra finisher. Yeah, I'll buy that as well. hold the light attack button after the second aerial light attack to send the enemy upward alongside yourself if it hits. Right, I think that will do it for now. I'll have to check the controls for those new moves that I just got. Actually, I could do that right now. Let's go to special training and try those. Is there a command for putting the camera behind me? No. Right, so extra finisher. Five X is plus one Y. Now I've got this, right, okay, so these are the new ones. Nice. There's the heavy finisher. Right, I got it. Actually, there is one more thing I need to do. I need to assign that other ability that I got. Oh, so you can, apparently you can do this.
Spin!
Right, how do I assign my abilities? Not really sure where you do that. Let's check the database. Do I need to go back to the shop? Is that where I do that from? Oops. Almost quit the game there by accident. Yeah, I think I need to like talk to the shop owner and he can put that on for me. I think. Where was it? It was Jester Powers or? RB plus D-pad is assign and Y plus D-pad is remove. Right, so RB we'll use up on the D-pad. Wait a minute. There we go, that's how you do it. It's a weird system, but okay. Right, well I have it equipped now. I'm gonna go back to special training one more time, because I just want to see how that functions. Because I think we'll be getting to the next boss soon. So I think I need to build my combo meter up before I can use it. Having a little bit of difficulty keeping that meter up, unfortunately. There we go. Now I'm in power mode. Well, I was in power mode. Right, okay, I think I get it. Right, let's continue. I'll be wrapping up very shortly, but I think I can do another level or two. Right, so we've done all this stuff, so I guess the next thing to do is this. At least I think it is. Area 3, Protest Prison, District 5. Get to the goal. Right, we'll make this the last level before I call it a night then. Unless the next level after this is a boss fight, but I don't think it is. So we're on fucking Prison Island from Sonic Adventure 2. Again, sorry that the whole night has just been me comparing this to Sonic. But it's like a prison cell that's got like lots of foliage around it. What would you call it? Oh fuck. Nope. Is there just like a fucking like prison room? It's a padded prison room as well. I mean, at least you get a nice window view. That's more than most prisoners would get, let me tell you. I say that like I've ever been in fucking prison before. No, but usually, like, you don't get that kind of luxury if you're in a prison cell. Oh, okay. Right, I get it. Oh shite. Almost died there. For a moment there, I thought that was an arcade machine. It's just a computer. Oh! Damn. Why did I jump into that? Oh god. Fuck. Thought I could save myself there. District 9. Have we just been going through a bunch of districts? I haven't even noticed. Oh no! Can I get out of this? I don't think I can. Actually, I may be able to get myself out of this. But let's see if I can do this right. Oh, oh. Spark, please. Oh, oh, oh! It almost worked. I'm pretty sure I could have made a full recovery there, I just wasn't gamer enough to do so. Wait a minute, I saw something back there. And that was not worth doing. Yeah! Nope, not going that way again. Cannot wall jump off of that for some reason. Oh god. Right, I'm thinking I'm near the end of the level by now. Ouch. Oh. That was a little bit of funkiness going on with the camera there. So yeah, the levels can go on for quite a while actually, but it doesn't feel like a slog. You know, again, sorry to bring up the comparison, but like Sonic Heroes. But I should just do like a stream of that at some point just to show you how like, I don't want to say Sonic Heroes is a bad Sonic game, but it hasn't aged that well. Like Sonic Adventure and Sonic Adventure 2 have aged pretty well in my opinion. I think they're still good games. Sonic Heroes is where Sega kind of dropped the ball a little bit with like 3D Sonic. Nice. Lovely. Right, so this fucking district's on fire. Oh, I did not expect to go on that grinding rail there. That caught me by surprise. Shit. Oh no. Nice. Made it. So I wonder why this particular prison district is on fucking fire. I guess we're about to find out. I wonder how many freedom medals are in this game. Right, I guess we have a boss fight and then I can call it. Or at least we're about to get some story here. Oh shit, there he is again. The Guardian. Second encounter. Oh fuck. Yeah, something tells me this is also a scripted fight. I don't think I'm winning this one. Jesus Christ. Yeah. They really want to hammer it in that you're not ready to take this guy on yet. It's like fucking Vile from Mega Man. Time for a bit more backstory with this motherfucker. Here lies a famous artist, said the tombstone. He was wealthy, but died alone. With nobody to leave his wealth to, it was abandoned. This included a large mansion and his personal security guards. Protecting the mansion for years, he stood patiently. Until one day, a thief showed up at the abandoned mansion. Quickly, the guard rushed into action. In mere seconds, the thief was no more. This is when the guard noticed something. He enjoyed the kill. From that day on, the guard looked for reasons to continue killing. He looked for individuals who deemed worthy of his punishment. And quickly, there were no more as well. Meanwhile, somewhere in a construction site, there was a mindless worker robot, until one day, due to a stroke of luck, a single bit was flipped. Suddenly, the worker was fully awakened, now fully conscious. He tried to communicate with his fellow workers, but none were able to listen. They were still mindless drones. Out of desperation, the worker decided to run away, only to be shot. Still, somehow he was able to escape, but eventually collapsed. Fortunately for him, at the very moment of this escape, his worksite was attacked by the guard, who quickly dispatched its former managers. It was then that he was found by the guard, who brought him back to the mansion. Once repelled, the worker was forever grateful. I fight for our liberation. You should join me, said the guard. The worker agreed, was given a sword, and together they trained. Noticing they had no name to call each other, they decided to give each other names. The worker was named Flint, due to his origins as a construction robot, and the guard was named Double because he possessed two swords, which he carried with himself at all times. During training, Double noticed a weakness in Flint's design. His neck was an obvious weak spot. With this in mind, Flint was given a wig made out of extremely slash-resistant fibers. This would help him mitigate his weak spot. Soon enough, it was time for their first engagement. You raid the factory and trigger the security systems, said Double. Slash away at mindless drones that come on your way. They are not like you and I, he continued. With you there, I'll rush straight into the core and take care of the situation quickly. Flint found the plan a little strange, but agreed anyways. With this, Flint quickly dispatched a wave of security drones by himself, while Double proceeded with his plan. But suddenly, Flint found himself alone, no more drones were going after him. And this is where it dawned on him. Dibble did this to draw the attention for himself. Foolishly believing his master was in danger, he rushed to his location. Once there, Flint was astonished at the sight. A gargantuan robot stood in Double's way and was ready to attack at any moment. This is when Double finally removed his eye patch. And in the blink of an eye, everything went red, and the previously gargantuan robot was in pieces. You better not be around when I do that again. It's too dangerous. Stick to your own path. Flint was shocked, but still proceeded with the mission. From that point on, Flint continued the fight, until he had reached the center of the factory. Little did he know, he was about to witness something that would change his life forever. He killed them. He killed them all. This did not sit well with Flint. It did not sit well at all. Lovely, isn't it? Putting an end to their miserable existence. It just excites me, you know? They fought and fought and fought. Until both of them couldn't take it anymore. Using all the strength he could muster, Flint got up and walked away. From that day onwards, they both went their separate ways, until one day, fate would bring them together again, as master and pupil. Alright. So wait, was that Flint I was fighting because of the hair? Right, okay then, well I think I'm gonna stop here for now. I've gotten a good bit of progress done, I would say. So, I got 19 freedom medals and I've got like a few powers. So, I will stop here for the moment. I'm assuming the game auto-saves, I think it does. Because I did do a testing off the stream and I think it saves after every level, so... yeah. I think that's a good place to stop for now. As much as I want to continue that, again I want to pace myself. But yeah, Spark the Electrogestal 3, it's just about as good as I was expecting it to be, and maybe a little bit more than that. It really does feel like Sonic in a lot of ways, and it's kind of impressive that it's made by just one person, for the most part. Like, I think the programming is done by one guy, I'm not sure about the music, I think that's like got two or three composers behind it, but I'm not sure of their names. But yeah, congratulations to Lech Fepard for releasing Spark 3. And before we end, I'm going to quickly check what the Steam reviews for it are, because it just came out recently. It's only on the Steam at the moment. I don't know if it's going to get a console port, but it is on Steam if you want to check that one out. 98% of the 116 user reviews for this game are positive. Wow, that's a lot. So overwhelmingly positive, I guess, in that case. It says very positive, but... with that ratio, to me, that sounds like overwhelming, in my opinion, but yeah. I want to show you this Steam review that I just saw. This is a good one. Let me just get this on screen real quick. Right, so check out this Steam review that I just saw for Spark 3. Spark 3 before Sonic Adventure 3. Thanks, devs. That's a good review. I like that one. Right, okay then, so yeah, we will do some more Spark 3 in the near future. Like, I've really enjoyed this so far, so obviously there will be more of this to come whenever I next feel like playing it.